does not have been added, you need to make sure that we take care of that. So if you're in that situation where you need to add a guest, don't check them in. We will do that. Because sometimes what happens is they'll cheat and they'll just go right in and not come to us at all. And they have already been checked in, so they're golden, right? So don't check them in. If they're going to add a guest, don't check them in. We will do that at the information table. And you can give their stuff to the floater, and the floater can walk them, and we'll receive their stuff and we'll take care of them. Does that make sense? Other couple notes that you will check for the person on the iPad. We have a couple notes that say send to PSC, EOP student, or balance due. If it says send to PSC, this is someone that they're getting a change in their admission status. So all you have to do if it, you know, once you click check in and it says that, you just need to grab a floater and say, hey, you know, this person needs to go to the Office of Admissions, and you can let that person know that I have a note here that you have to visit the Office of Admissions, and then that's it. That's all you have to say. You don't have to go into any further detail. EOP student, this is just for us because, as many of you know, EOP students do have a first contact, like, information session that they attend in the summer, and they're given a general catalog. So they already have one. They don't need a second one. So what we'll do is we'll ask them if they have a catalog today, and if they do, then great. If they don't, the person who's giving the backup will take out, if they have their catalog with them, you'll take out the one that that we have, because again, they don't need a second one. But if they don't have it, it's okay, just let them keep it. Balance due, just someone that missed the announcement in the morning, that's, it will notify you, and you just want to make sure that you send that person to the information table. The stuff, their folder, has to be given to a floater, and they take them over to our information table. Yeah.
If send to PSC comes up, there won't even be a backpacker
folder. Correct. So we already talked about second person looking for the folder and the name tags. Third person will give the folder. They're the ones that are, you know, if they're an EOP student, we'll ask if they brought their catalog. If they did, if they didn't, remove it. If they brought it, great. And then,
with the catalog, it's so important this year. It's always important, but it's so important this year because we have more freshmen coming than originally was planned for. And so we really need every catalog that we ordered. So please really, like Amy said, pay really special attention to this EOP note. And if they didn't bring it, don't forget to make a note that you gave them one of ours, because I have to get another catalog from another department to backfill other orientation units. Does that make sense? It's a little bit, we're tighter on the materials this year because we have more freshmen. So.
And then that last person, again, we'll direct them to Montezuma Hall. Also, and I forgot to include this on here, you want to make sure that you let them know that they have to wear their name tag. It is their ticket into the session and their lunch ticket as well. So it just really helps us. It will help you identify who our participants are. So whoever's giving that folder, you know, say, hey, you know, if they're your name test, please make sure that you put them on right now. It's your entrance into the session. Okay? Yes.
What would you do if the student doesn't have any form of ID, like they don't have a driver's license or a paper ID?
I mean, it's very rare at a lot of
What Tessa told me last year was that if they don't have any ID, the personalized academic folder, if you open it on the first page, it actually has their address. So then just ask them to confirm their address to you. And then for the most part, usually that's okay, because then they'll have their red ID. So if they have their red ID and their address, they should be fine. That should be them. But that was what Tessa had advised.
I think that's perfect, but what you need, I think you were about to say, is it's super rare they don't have it. We have told them 100 times they have to bring a valid form of ID, list what a valid form of ID is, but that's another way. And if they can rattle stuff off like that, you know that, you know,
yes.
Probably they're out of
it. That is very, yeah, and it's very rare, but yes, you could do that. Yeah,
someone? I was just going to say, like, with the situation, you really have to watch, because sometimes people will say that they're not bringing a guest, so the person will be in the front of them. And then the guests will stand to the side, and they'll try to sneak into the program. Mm-hmm. Because they know you have to pay to get
into the program.
So that's when they say, like, oh, no, they're not coming in, it's like you can tell a floater, like, just kind of like, you don't have to stare at them, but just be mindful. mindful that they might try to like just sneak it.
And then,
sometimes you'll find out at lunch.
And then the bottom line is that person doesn't know. Again, we have this like way crazy behind the scenes little operation. So the next person they see at the base of the stairs is going to say, put your name tag on. And then the person they see at the top of the stairs, right, is going to notice it nonstop. And then Kristen and team is going to actually stop them, probably if no one else has, and said, if you haven't checked in, you need to escort you downstairs. You're going to get escorted downstairs. And they're going to say they don't want to pay for somebody. People are shady. They just are. We've seen it all. So try to get it and check in. Like Simone is saying, it's the best time to handle it. You can see if there's someone with them or if they have additional guests and they have to pay as part of the program. Because then they come at lunch, and this is what they say to Frankie, me, and Eunice at the parent table. My ambassador gave me my name tag. And we go, oh, okay. On an iPad. What's your student's name and red ID? Well, you're not registered for the program. You say it a lot nicer than that. But do you see how they're constantly trying to be shady? So, and it's kind of sad, but it's too many for people, I guess. But really watch it, catch it at check-in, and it should be a smooth kick.
It also makes it a little bit challenging once they make it into Montezuma Hall, because then, you know, myself or another ambassador will go up to student or guest, and it just makes it a little bit awkward to sort of catch it before they get into Montezuma Hall. That's ideal.
We got
another
question really quick. Emily mentioned special assistance. You will know ahead of time if your table or someone has it, so don't worry about that. We will remind you. You'll hear it in the morning meeting. But myself or Emily will also remind you, like, hey, look out for so-and-so. We have a wheelchair reserved for them. And check in floaters as well. I mean, sometimes it's a little obvious because they're in crutches or something, and you can help us out with that. And, like, you know, they don't necessarily have to wait in line. I mean, if you want to be nice and just do it behind the scenes, that's great. Again, we want to be very customer service. Parent package, which you all are very familiar with, I hope, look like this. So this will go to our parents that have registered, and it's one per family. So one parent package per family, that's very important. If they insist, let's say that it's a divorced household, we want to make sure to let them know that during lunchtime would be the perfect opportunity for them to visit the Asynchron Association's tent, where Frankie, myself, and Michelle will be there, and we can help them get a second parent packet, and plus, we want to let them know that we want to verify that we have their information as a separate household, so we can send them, you know, our mailings and everything that we do as part of the association. If they're really, really giving you a hard time, send them over to our table as well, the information table, and we can help with that. But most of the time, parents are really great and they understand. Again, if you tell them that we just want to make sure that we have their information, then lunchtime would be a great time.
And sometimes, sometimes there is situations where they're divorced, but they're both attending the orientation, and it's not an amicable situation, and so Eunice and Emily do a great job of taking care of them before lunch, so they have materials to call along, and we take care of them. And it's a household membership, so, you know, both families will always get the information. Cap, where's Cap? What you never want to do, and this is for all of you too, but Kat really is your go-to when you're with parents. You never, ever want to come in to Montezuma Hall with parent packets. Because every parent, why would they want another packet, right? It's another set of information, I might have missed a handbook, now I have another one. And they see that, and people start raising their hands. So that happened a couple years ago, and I was on stage behind the podium, like, going, huh? Like, trying to figure out a way to get them to stop because we only have a certain amount of packets to pass out as it is. So be mindful of all those things like supplies. You don't just want to pass out supplies. Cat with parent packets. You know, it's one per household except for these situations. We've charted over the years and we usually end up passing out over the course of all of the programs about 250 extra parent packets to interesting split households or just interesting situations. But let us handle that.
Just for the guest thing about keeping out an eye out for like extra guests, that's when the floaters really come into play about having the people stand a couple feet back. That way, like, when a family goes up to the table, you know that their whole party's at the table. Whereas, like, if the line is right at your table, it's happened that I don't know who's who because the line's at the table. And, like, I've confused two people. Two people come to me, and I'm like, oh, are you together? And they're totally separate families. So
that's excellent. Do you guys remember when we were with, when we were in the courtyard yesterday, we were talking about, like, the ATM concept where you kind of step up and you keep this five-foot gap or whatever it is. So whoever is in that position, it's so important that you do that, and that will help alleviate some of the things that Simone brought up about not knowing who's who or someone trying to sneak in without paying. Really good. Really, really good. Remember, we're in charge of facilitating it, you know? And they will follow what we say. We just need to be on them with how we want the process to go.
So I'm going to pretend to be a student. Some will have the red ID, so great.
Most freshmen will not.
But some. I'm just a very prepared one. All right, so we're going to, you know, they're going to do their, whatever thing that they say, okay?
Hi, welcome to SJCU. Thank you. Did you know your red ID number?
Yes. 811-23-269.
Perfect. How many guests with you today?
One guest.
Awesome. They'll hand you all your materials right there. Welcome back to
this.
She'll be talking to someone while I'm checking in the next person.
Okay. Awesome.
Hi, welcome to SJCU. Do you have an ID? Perfect, thank you. Do you know your red ID number?
811-23-269.
Awesome. How many guests with you today?
One.
Perfect. We'll hand you all your materials. Hi, welcome to SJCU. Do you have your ID?
Here are all your materials for the day.
Perfect. Do you have a photo ID?
Both
of
you can
can do is like, oh, can you read it to me? And then it's easier for him to punch in rather than like reading the card, punching in the number, me looking for the ID. So usually that helps if you tell them to read it to you too.
And if they hand you your ID right away and you give it to her, she can start looking for that folder while I'm still completing the check-in, because you'll have, you know, like, what, 50 to 100 folders?
Yeah.
So she'll have to find all
of them. Just going off of what Michelle said, be fast and efficient, but don't make them feel rushed. Like, they're not, like, you want to be warm and welcoming to them.
I think, like, if you want to kick it up a notch, you know, be, like, extra helpful, maybe just opening up their blue folder and just taking a peek at their major, and maybe just telling them, like, oh, you'll be sitting in the class you're engineering today. So just when you go upstairs, like, the class you're engineering center, whatever the case may be, because they might get nervous and might forget, but a lot of them are going to kind of retain that information and know what to do as soon as they get up there. So just to kind of help out the process, so you won't cause like a major congestion upstairs and they're trying to find out what college you're in, just giving them like a, oh yeah, you're in the